Kelly!
Hello, how are you? Oh my God, it's nearly there.
Oh yeah.
How are you feeling?
Wow.
Yeah.
Great.
Jürgen, do you know the phrase or the quotation, people might not remember what you said, they might not remember what you did, but they will always remember how you made them feel. Have you heard that before?
Yeah, but I don't know who said it.
Maya Angelou said it.
Okay. Yeah.
But the point is that I've spoken to so many people that knowing I was coming here to talk to you today and ask them what their memories were. And it's the first thing everybody mentions is how they feel about the club with you as its manager. What do you make of that connection? How do you feel about that connection?
It's super special. We had now just before that, we had the players goodbye. They wanted to say goodbye, and it was as well about how they feel, how they felt. It is like that. We all felt home. We all felt welcomed. That's what we all felt from the start. That's a special thing about the people in this area. The Scousers is really special. We felt supported, we felt loved, we felt everything, and yes, we delivered as well in moments. And we always fought, and that's again is what the people expect. And so it was the biggest win-win situation I ever saw and experienced in my lifetime, because nothing would have happened without the people here, and maybe not exactly the same would have happened if somebody else would have been in charge. So it was just, it fitted like a glove from the first day and until today. And that's why it's so tricky and emotional to say goodbye, even knowing it's 100% right, the right thing to do. But probably meanwhile, a lot more people see the same way than in January when I announced it. And I'm really happy about the fact that we put this team on the rails, and now somebody else will come in and help them to make the decisive yards.
You talked about the connection that you feel, and I know you spent some time at Anfield when it was empty, standing on the cop when it was empty. Obviously it's not the same thing as being able to do it when it's full. But what were you thinking about when you were looking around?
Why did you do that on the last day and not on the first? Funny enough, at Dortmund I was the first time on the yellow wall, on the stand, which you call the yellow wall, on the last day. Yeah. That makes no sense. So if next time I would do it on the first day. I'm first and foremost, if we have to be honest here, so I got asked to do that. Not that I had, that was my idea and go there. So we are obviously in a world where we have to try to create pictures. And on that day we had, I said goodbye to the Liverpool staff. They were in the stadium, and our guys, people used the opportunity to make some nice pictures, and it was from that. I wouldn't have gone there and just for myself and go in the stadium. I love Anfield, but I love Anfield when it's full. I love Anfield when it's rocking. I love Anfield when we go for something. It's a nice place, but my imagination is not good enough to see the place empty and then thinking, how would that look when people were there? I need people in. And that's why it's good that I did it. And maybe we created some nice pictures, but I will not miss an empty Anfield, but I will miss definitely rocking Anfield at its best. But the idea is to be part of it from time to time in the stands and follow and support the next steps of the team.
What is it like to experience that rocking atmosphere that you talk about from the dugout when you're sitting there and you can see that everybody, especially on things like flag days or when there's a big European night, how does that feel?
Outstanding. It's just the best you can get. It's like when you dream as a kid of playing on highest level or then when you're an adult player and want to dream of coaching on the highest level, you dream of big occasions, but you cannot dream of something like that because it's unreal. And then you arrive here and people make it real. That's absolutely special. It's really difficult to describe because I'm not even sure the problem is that I'm not native. It's just difficult to describe. You have to experience it. And we all here in the room obviously had it. And we all know it's exactly, and I'm not sure anybody here could really describe it, but we all had it. And we all know the influence, the impact it has. We all know what the Kop can do to a game. We all know what Anfield can do to an opponent. But it has to be equal to the performance. Anfield without a good team is not exactly the same like Anfield with a really good football team. And for a long period, we were maybe one of the best teams in Europe between 18 and 20. Maybe we were the best team in Europe. It felt exceptional. And only the last part was obviously without supporters. Before that was with supporters. And there we really showed what togetherness can do to your own, to yourself. And that was absolutely outstanding. I will never forget that. Nobody will ever forget it. If it was one day, it's like you walk out and they sing You Never Walk Alone. And it's never the same. Never, ever is the same. And I don't know how many home games I had, 200 something. And it was not one time the same. It's always special. And that's only because of the people.
And the rich history of the club as well. And that's the second thing that's been talked about so much from within the club, which is your ability to respect history while at the same time writing your own pages in it. Did you find that a difficult balance, or was it something that you set out to do? Or?
No, not at all. I don't know exactly why nobody said it before, to be honest, but I don't think, for me it's completely common sense. So I love football history. I'm a football romantic. I know your dad, I loved your dad, and ever had the players from that time, but we cannot do what they did for plenty of reasons. Just not possible. If you ask the people today, why did Liverpool win? I heard only yesterday that when they became champion in 1990, it was pretty much like champion again, because they were just used to it. And nobody could say, why don't nobody gets close? And that stops in that moment. Then you can explain why you never get close again. So history is wonderful to think about. And if history can push you, use it. If history holds you back, keep it aside. And that's what I said on the first day. We cannot carry it in a backpack with us. The people cannot constantly compare this Liverpool team with better teams from the past. Because otherwise, how will one make the next step? And again, what I said on the first day, nobody likes the team. Not even the team likes the team. That's a really crazy situation. So I came in, and when I came in, I was the only guy in the room who loved the football team we had. It was one of the reasons why I signed for Liverpool, because I really liked a lot of players. Didn't know all of them perfectly, but knew enough to say, that's a start. And that might have been the start for absolutely everything. And I enjoyed all the steps we had to make. We learned so much how patient the people are in a really not very patient world when they see a development in the right direction. Then they don't ask for step 3 and 4 immediately. Then they are ready to make all the necessary steps. And that's what we learned here. That's what I hope that the people will keep. Because the future is bright, but there's some work to do, obviously.
I think that probably started with that doubters to believers comment, which I think was off the cuff, wasn't it?
It was.
Yeah. And yet that seemed to frame
Claire
so much, particularly of those early days.
I think Claire asked me the question in that interview. She asked me what kind of message, and I had a few interviews in my life, and this is the most difficult moment. What kind of message do we have to the public? I said that, stay healthy, have fun, whatever. And it came up in that moment. We have to change from doubter to believer. And then next day was a press conference, said it again there. And it was obviously the start for something special, but I would love to say I planned it, but I didn't. It was just came off the cuff.
But it was that framing that led to moments like the game against Dortmund with a late winner. There were so many incredible moments over your time, culminating obviously in the comeback against Barcelona. But even the near misses, even getting to the Europa League final, getting to the Champions League final, but being beaten by Real Madrid, that led on to further success. And it was, but you carried the crowd with you and said, this is a start, not as far as we can reach. This isn't the end of it.
No, we had to grow together again. That's clear. So we had to, I mix up the games a little bit. Could have been a Crystal Palace game, stuff like this. Not a great game. I think we drew it. But when I turned around, people left the stadium like 15 minutes before the end of the game. And I thought, eh? That's strange. So press conference after the game, and obviously I'm not shy of saying what I think. That I cannot, that was always like that. I don't want to offend anybody, but if something is not right, I said, in 15 minutes, or maybe it's 5 minutes, you can score 3 or 4 goals. It's possible. But if he gives a sign from the outside that we don't believe in that anymore, how could the players, they're young people, they have 80 minutes in their legs, they breathe like old horses, it's really intense, and then all of a sudden people tell them, we don't believe, I don't think you will do that, and go. How will that work? A few weeks later, or maybe 2 weeks later, or 1 week later, West Brom, late equalizer. As far as I saw it, stadium was still, the people were still there. And we said, thank you. That was one of the biggest misunderstandings in public, because I think Tony Pulis that time said, well, if Liverpool celebrates a draw against West Brom like that, what's going wrong in the football world with the money they spend? and we only want to say thank you. Not celebrating that we drew against West Brom, we want to say thank you. And again, there was another important step. And it was not on purpose in the sense of, come on, we have to do this and that to bring the people over. It was just the honest thing to do, what we felt. Thank you for supporting us until the last whistle. Thank you. And then, step by step, we arrived there. And of course, we all need these special moments like the Dortmund game where we turned it around late. Incredible atmosphere and all these kind of things. In early stages, when we were 1-0 up, the people were with each pass, we didn't play forward, they were like, oh my God, we pass, we will concede. So we had to go through all the things. Then we had the year where we were always leading or winning, and then we conceded equalizer, so because we couldn't control the game well enough. So we started controlling the game. That cost us a little bit exciting attacking football, but we came back to that. And so we made all the necessary steps. But usually, and that's a special thing in football, you don't get the time for that. And the special thing that, so I don't know exactly what the people thought at that time, but I know what our owners thought. They were completely calm and didn't get nervous and thought, but we should already, or we have to already. And that gave us the time to create a really special football team. And in my opinion, we did that again. Our set steps to go. But we have again a pretty special squad here. And they deserve a manager on the top of his own game. And that's what they will get.
Do you think that sort of emotional side of the game overshadows sometimes the sort of technical improvements and the brilliance at times of what's going on the pitch, that sometimes people say, oh, Liverpool, that they're such an emotional team. They're just kind of getting by on vibes, basically. So do you think that overshadows what the players are doing sometimes?
I have actually no clue how the outside world sees us.
Do you care?
No. So I cannot really say that. It's not overshadowed for me. So, and I don't know how that might be outside, in the outside world. So it's a mix of everything. So we don't have to make football bigger than this. I mean, this moment, I'm leaving, and it feels like it's the most important subject in the world, but the world is still a pretty crazy place, and me leaving Liverpool should not be in the 8 o'clock news. So let me say it like that. But I understand 100%, we have to do it properly, and we do that. But if football would not be emotional, that we don't have the right to exist, really. If you want to be, if you want to watch something different, then you have to watch something different. You cannot watch football, then you should not play football if you're not ready to throw absolutely everything in on the level we play. The people, so many people all the world, it means the world to them during these 90 minutes. So we have to give our all. And to give your all without emotion is absolutely not possible. You cannot be always controlled and pass the ball here and pass the ball there and chip it over him. That doesn't work like that. And that's what I love the most about the game, is the mix of all these pieces, like tactical things, like physical things, like emotions and all these kind of things. So and that makes football so super special. And the people here see football as kind of a mirror of their life. So it's not, we don't have the best circumstances, we don't have the best upcoming month, sometimes if you want, we have struggles here, difficulties here. But when we are together, we can conquer the whole world. And that's what we want to do and what we want to see. I think Liverpool, that's what we achieved in the last 9 years. I think Liverpool, when we talk about Liverpool in the world, outside world, they know Liverpool for the right reasons again. So like maybe 10 years ago, they said, people would have said in America, without telling them, oh, I'm from Liverpool. Said, oh, you used to have a good football team. So now maybe they said for the last 9 years, oh, you have a really good football team. And it's cool. It's cool to do that for the people. So wherever you go, Liverpool, oh, Beatles are from him. Oh, LFC, really good footballer. So these kind of things, that's the job we have to do. We are kind of the ambassadors for these kind of things to the outside world because it's such a massive club. So we have to do well. And we did as well as we could, I would say.
And there's the trophies to back it up. A first league title in 30 years. To put that into context, I was 14, I had a perm and braces. which is why I haven't brought a photo to show you of it. Yeah. But you know, you look back and you think your time here at Liverpool, you think 9 years and it's gone so quickly. But 30 years.
That's crazy.
Before there was another title. And you and the players managed to deliver that. I think 25 points clear when football shut down for COVID. And you did it in the most incredible of circumstances.
We did. Super special. Yeah, look, I can see it like that. This is super special. And I'm fine with one Premier League title. Like, I look back already. So that's not, I don't regret these kind of things. But it could or maybe should have been more. That's the truth as well. And I stand that view as well, that people say, but yeah, here you should have done better, here you should have. The thing is just, we gave our all. So where can you start changing? I know we gave absolute everything and it led us to 1 point behind the other team. So there was nothing to criticize. You cannot pick out on such a long journey. It's like you run a marathon and you don't win it. And you think at kilometer 12, I had one misstep and it cost me the race. It didn't. You could have catch up 12 times after that. It depends how you deal with it. And we dealt with all the setbacks really well. And some of them were not in our hands. We had nothing to do with that. We played 3 Champions League finals, which is absolutely insane. Before that, we didn't qualify for a while, so I know all that. But then arriving at the final and not getting silver medals in football, yeah, to get a silver medal actually, but not.
Do you know where yours is?
It's not great.
Do you even know where yours is? Your runners up medal?
One of them has actually a friend of mine.
Yeah.
Yeah, if I'm honest, I gave it to him and I thought he will not take it, but okay. Yeah. And there it goes. And yeah, the other, I know absolutely. I have another one from Dortmund.
Yeah.
I have a collection of silver medals. Great.
And but a winner's medal.
Yeah, exactly. That makes all the difference. The difference between losing a final, winning a final, that's my English really not good enough to describe that. So it's worth all the effort. But we were not the favorites to go where we went in the end. We weren't the favorites to, nobody said before the Champions League, oh, Liverpool, we were definitely in the final. Next year, Liverpool. Definitely the final. We qualified first time through the qualification, actually, the playoffs, and went to the final and lost it in the most strange circumstances, I would say. I don't think a lot of people said, oh, we have another chance next year. We thought we go again. The special thing about the story is we don't become champion pretty much a day before the semi-final in the Champions League. So we for a goal from Vincent Kompany, but and you deal with that. And again, it's the Liverpool way, and not a knock. We are used to that. Get up and go again. And we went again and played one of the most extraordinary football games of all times against Barcelona. So not becoming chairman, and finally at the weekend, and then 3 weeks' time, and we win the Champions League final. It's absolutely crazy. So all these things are so special, and some will see it as exceptionally successful, and some will see it, we didn't win enough. And what I can say, both might be right, but we cannot change it anymore. So take it or don't take it. I can't help you.
But there were also, you talk about moments that maybe didn't go Liverpool's way, but there were also the moments that the team did fight for. I'm thinking of the Origi goal, 90+6 against Everton, the Alisson goal, 90+5 against West Brom in lockdown, which actually went a long way to helping Liverpool and Champions League qualification, where they ended up in the final at Paris. So there are all those sort of small moments along
absolutely.
The way.
Absolutely. But it is what I mean, that's true. And we had probably more moments. The Norwich was a special moment for different reasons, but a really special moment. And the thing is, it's really like that we really always deal with the situation in the right way, in the Liverpool way. That's how I understand it. That's our job to do. There were these top moments and there were really harsh moments, but to give up was not possible. And you could see it. Outstanding season. We gave absolutely everything. Big problems next season. It's not because we were not consistent. It's not because I put the feet on the table and thought, another season or what? We wanted to go with all we had. We wanted to do it, but we couldn't. Injuries, bam, bam, bam. So then we qualified. After we became champion, obviously that was the season when we then became third because of Ali's header, blah, blah, blah. Go to the Champions League final again. And then we have the four nearly quadruple season and then a horrible season after that because then the summer break is too short and all these kind of things. Nobody wants to hear that, but we have to deal with it. It's like it is. I cannot make breaks bigger or shorter or whatever. Human beings need a specific time to rest mentally and physically. And we took it. And again, and the people took it as well. Not that they were overly happy that we are now not playing great, but they were not angry with us in a way. I cannot remember a whistling, do we call it as well, concert when everybody's whistling in a stadium and they were really against the team. Yeah, they were not happy and slightly disappointed, but there came nothing between us. In these tricky moments, we still were a real, real unit. And that's the life lesson. As long as that is there, you always can come back. In a moment when a bad situation leads to a really bad situation, it's much more difficult to find back on track. And that's why we always came back, then the season after, like this year. People might say it's not a great season, but becoming third is in a really strong league is a good result. Not the result, but it's a good result. The new Champions League is coming up. You have to be part of that. You have to be, as a club of our size, you have to be part of it, and we are part of it. A second year not in the Champions League is a massive problem for Liverpool. So we did that, and now let's go from there.
It must have been such an emotional up and down time. Since you announced that you were leaving the club to now, you must have gone through all kinds of emotions. It feels like at the moment you're almost dwelling on the almosts, on those points that maybe could have been a little bit better. As much as you're saying, well, people might say, you know, this moment was where the title was lost by a point, or this moment was maybe where we lost the Champions League final. Is that where you are in your head at the moment?
No. But I saw recently, a few days ago, I saw Pep Guardiola speaking about us. I just saw the headline, Liverpool is not a failure. And I thought, okay, let's have a look. Yeah. What's that about? And he's right. The chances we created, the boys didn't fail. The chances we created in a specific period where we didn't deliver the results. I think football is meanwhile a real statistic game, so everybody knows everything and you have expected goals, stuff like that. I'm pretty sure the expected goals were completely outrageous, and on the other side, the decisive number was nil or one or whatever. Is that to explain? No, not really. It was, we were sitting there and looking at it and thought, wow, again, wow. We missed chances, it was crazy. And it's not on purpose. I tell you, the boys want desperately to put the ball in the back of the net, bring it over the line. So there's nothing what I can see as a call. Why you didn't score? It's not possible. We have to make sure that we get that often in a situation that the boys are able to use these opportunities. In that period, for 3-4 games, we were not able to use it. So, and that decides on highest level, that decides the season. That's why I said we were the third best team in the league. Nobody wants to hear that, but it's a fact. If we would have scored the goals in that, we would fight on the weekend with the other guys. I know that. That's a matter of fact. But we can, that's now past already, and that's, I'm fine with it. I'm not a guy who is now in that situation and think, oh my God. We had so many situations. We have so many opportunities to stay in the past and just think, come on, this situation, you have to whistle differently, this we need other decision, all this kind of thing. There were so many awkward moments. They are unexplainable to me, but they happened. We are all human beings and we have all the same things crossing our mind. But in the end, I need to get calm again around the games and prepare the team for the next game. And we did that very, very, very often. Close to perfection, because the boys played incredible football over the years.
But that's the nature of the title race. In the time that you've been at Liverpool, the title races have been so close, and there've been points totals reached that have never been reached before. They are different levels that are required of any team that's going to be going now for the Premier League title.
Absolutely. This year, obviously, you don't need that many. You need a few, but not that many. But you see it. We will see what happens at the weekend. But as a club, if it's not your own situation, you're not really bothered about it. So you look at the situation, Son, the 1-1 situation with Ortega. That was 100% a situation like Iheanacho against City. I'm not sure it was a goalie that time. Probably it was Ederson. So when Kompany scores a goal, and then shortly after that, Iheanacho has a 1-1 situation with the goalie and doesn't score. It was a breakdown in Liverpool. Now it's a breakdown in Arsenal. In the end, it's City who wins it. So can you explain that? It's one action for a goalie. And we do like everything else doesn't count. But in decisive moments, you need these kind of things. And we had it in the year when we became champions very often. And the other years not often enough, because the competitor was pretty good as well. We have to say that. And that's just a fact. And I'm fine with what we did. And I respect all the opinions. It's enough, it's fantastic, or it's not enough. It's all fine. It's your own opinion. I can live with that as well. But first and foremost, I have to be in peace with it, and I am.
Those levels that you talk about reaching, you talk about the Liverpool way, you talked about your kind of affinity with the people of the city and the city itself. Do you understand, for those reasons, why the comparisons have been made between you and Bill Shankly?
No, that's too big, obviously, to like. There's no chance to really get a phrase where my name is used in the same phrase with Bill, Bob, or Kenny. It just doesn't get down. So it's just different levels. But I understand. I was not there, obviously, and how it all we always get is glorified. Do you use that? I probably Bill. 100% sure he was a great guy, fantastic. But 100% you look back, and he gets glorified. So it's like. Yeah, absolutely a perfect human being. He did everything right. Socialist, great figure, blah, 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 blah. So, and that's what's happened with me now. So I'm who I am, and a few things are better and other things are worse, but because I was here when people were really not happy with it, we all together re-energized the club 100%. It was not in great place. People, as I said, people didn't like the team. Team didn't like the team. Blah blah blah. We create incredible atmospheres. We are where we belong 100% again. And I was the manager of that team when that happened. So I understand that people bring that together with me. But now, when we had the farewell with the players, they tried really prepare wonderful, blah, blah, blah. All the trophies we won were there on the little stage. And they said goodbye to the whole coaching staff, all the people who live. But on the stage was only Jürgen Klopp. And I said, that we do that today speaks absolutely and describes you as a team the best, your character and all those kind of things. Why is he Jürgen Klopp? I mean, 7-8 people leave. And I just want to make sure I know what they did. You know what they did. So don't make it about me. But that's the world we are living in. But I understand. So I have my big strength is bring people together who are really good at what they are doing. I'm not too bad as well. I know that. But that's my biggest strength. We had the perfect coaches, the perfect stuff and all this kind of thing. That's what we created over 9 years, and that's why the boys could deliver on the pitch like they delivered. So I know exactly my impact and stuff like that, and I'm happy with that we brought the club back where it belongs. But obviously being in the same phrase with the three other fellas, it's really tricky. I cannot get that really.
In itself, that's quite a Liverpool answer. <as well>. So, but tell me about that team, the team that won the Champions League, the team that won the Premier League title after those decades of waiting for Liverpool fans and the qualities that they had.
The good fun about it was that we had a good team when I arrived. We qualified for the European League final, and people go back and he wasn't good enough. He wasn't good. We qualified for the European League final. We had played incredible games. Would we have been champion years later with this team? No chance. But for that time, that was the team, good teams. But we had to change it step by step, and we did. Players coming in, yeah, we always talk, of course, about, and it's rightly so, Ali, Virch, Mo, before that, Sadio, incredible, incredible player, Gini Wijnaldum, incredible player, Andy Robertson, incredible, Fabinho, incredible player, Joel Matip, incredible player, like so many things that we had to put together. In the end, we created a specific way of football. And it was, did we invent the false nine? I don't know, it probably Bobby Firmino invented it, but did we invent the being a striker with Sadio and Mo? I'm not sure, but we used it in a very special way. We had we created the most offensive fullbacks. We played an incredible high line, rightly so, which leads then always to, if you concede a goal, that the line is too high, from your colleagues. Love that, yeah.
And they're very conservative.
Yeah, they are. Yeah, that's why they don't work. They work with you and not here. But it leads to, you create that, and it leads to that they say, yeah, but the midfield doesn't score often enough. And you just think, oh my God. Yeah, you're right. Midfield doesn't score often enough. That's absolutely right. So, but we really, step by step, piece by piece, we put a team together who became a machine. My idea always was, I want to be the coach who can beat the best. In moments, I like to be the best team, but actually that's a moment. I want to be always ready to be the best. That's the team I want. I want to be, I've been a big coach of the team who nobody wants to play against, for the reason that we go for them and we come to that in a second because I want to speak about it, but in a really fair way. I don't want to kill them. I don't want to jump into them. I don't want to use dark arts. I want to be all over them for winning the ball and not for giving free kicks away. And we were that team for a pretty long time. In that period, while we were building that team, we were, I think, pretty sure, 5 times in a row, the fairest team in England, 4 times the fairest in Europe. That was not a headline on no internet, on nothing, no Sky Show, nothing. For me, super important, for the outside world, rather, if I would have been a bit more dirty, you would have won more. So it's like, it's really, and it, okay. So, but we did it in a really, in a proper way. And the proper way is for me the Liverpool way. We don't have everything, but we can, but we still can fight for everything. That's how it is, and that's what we always tried. And how is that? These 2.5, 3 years, maybe I don't know how many games we won, and these kind of the points we had, the points tally is crazy. That was a real machine. Nobody wanted to play against, and whenever you would have woke them up, they would have gone for you and for each other and stuff like this through the fire. That was absolutely outstanding. And we are, and then you have to rebuild, then you have to do it again, and that's what we did. And then players get older and get used to things and don't defend as much anymore. So, and they're still the same players, but you cannot keep everything up for 4, 5, 6 years. So you have to make little changes. Sometimes you made them too late. Yeah. Because somebody scores 20 goals a season, and you tell him after the season, we sell him. Because next year we'll not only score 10, that would be a great situation. So it's tricky to stay successful. But we were always around, and again, I wouldn't be in peace with it if I could have done more. I couldn't have done more. Could I have done better? Yeah, of course. But only knowing today, at the time, no, because that was all I knew at the time.
When you were at Mainz, when you were at Dortmund, and now at Liverpool, you've been able to choose when you wanted to go. You've been that doesn't happen to many managers. Once in their career, let alone three times, and I think it speaks a lot to what you've managed to achieve at all of those clubs. But what is it for you that changes? What's the point for you where you think, no more? I've my job is done here.
There are different reasons. You cannot compare that. So Mainz was obviously we. First time in the not so great history of a wonderful club. We got promoted, stayed 3 years in the Bundesliga and got relegated. I could have gone everywhere in the Bundesliga to each other club, blah, 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 but decided, no, I want to stay. I want to get promoted again. We didn't, became fourth, and it was clear and clear with the club. Now we are all ready for a new start. The club needs a new start and I need a new start. That was the reason there. Not tired, not blah, 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 drained, whatever, just ready for a new challenge. Came up, Dortmund, do what you do. I would say we squeezed pretty much out everything, lost every year players, important players, which is really hard. So people, you become champion and people expect you to become champion again, but they buy the best player. Tell me one team in the world that become champion and they buy the best players of you. Just the other competitor in the league. So it's like City becomes champion and United buys four players of City. And then City has to become champion again. It's like these kind of things. So that is really intense. It's really intense because you have your own expectations. First, you have the disappointment that you cannot keep the players. Then you have to, but you have the ambition to go again. Then you realize it's not immediately possible. So you become second, which is fine. But with 15, 16, 17 points behind the other team, and it was hard. And at one point, I felt, that's the similar part, I felt if there's now two opportunities, then it's not similar, but it's where I felt I'm not the right one anymore, or we have to change the team a lot. And that we couldn't do that for financial reasons, for whatever, you cannot just put seven players out and say, and buy six. And there's no market for the other seven, stuff like this. So it was a clear decision for the club and saying, okay, this is a fantastic team. Just in a combination with me, there would be necessary to change something. It's not possible, so I leave. Fine. And I was ready for a new challenge. Had a little break and came here. And this is... I fell in love with the club and the city pretty quickly. My responsibility grew every day, the feeling the responsibility, the actual responsibility grew as well, but the responsibility I felt for the people I work with and for the people I don't even know or just know they are here and in the city grew every day. And there was a day when a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, when I realized I can't do that anymore. A football season, and you know that again, from my father, you play the season. Why you play the season? You plan the next season. So it's not, that we don't talk about it, but it's constant. I watch players, or I used to watch players we signed 2 years later, 2 years before. You start watching them. It's just you follow them. You have a look. Well, how's development? Blah, 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 speak to them. And that's how it goes. And I didn't have the power to do it anymore. And that's not possible. You cannot do it like that. So I can do that for a week and say, come on, you can do it next week. But it was not that I have no time. I just couldn't get up for it anymore. So it was immediately clear, okay, here I have to stop. I always said, in the moment I realized I'm not the right manager for the club anymore, I will tell. And that's what I did. And since then, I didn't have one doubt. It was not one second where I thought, And now people might say, that was too early. Since then, this and that happened. The alternative is, I don't tell. Or I get a sack. But I don't tell. And we play tomorrow game, Sunday the game. And after the game, I have the speech and say, that's it. That would have been for the club an absolute catastrophe in this manager market right now. Have a look. How many are available? We would say, oh yeah, he's a good choice. Or he. It's just too late. Again, coming back to responsibility. The responsibility is that big that I had to decide it early, and the club needed to know early, and we needed to announce early, because in the world you are living, everybody's waiting for a news like that, and can we get it out? It would have been impossible to keep it under the carpet for that long, and that's why we announced it. And now we have to live with the consequences, if you want.
How have match days been for you?
Since we cannot be champion anymore, pretty relaxed. Before that, business as usual. Business as usual, completely. As is until now, it's actually business as usual. I know Sunday is different, but I only know it. I don't feel it yet. And it's more, I'm a very pragmatic person. That means I tell myself, last match day and after the match is holiday. It's like it is every year. So far I could make myself believe that. And I know on Sunday after final whistle that will be completely different. Probably before the game, during the game, definitely. I will not be the most focused of my whole career. Let me say it like that. I might get a few more voices from around me, which I usually cut off completely. So it's special, and it's very special and very unique, because last game at Mainz was the game, if we would have won it, we would have got promoted. That means I would have stayed, and it was a tight game, and we needed other result in the other stadium, so we were full in the game, nobody thought about that, it was just clear, game over, how the other team play, and it was clear, if we don't get promoted, I leave. So that's when it started to think about. So completely not prepared. Okay, he's going. Wow. Dortmund, we played the final in the German FA Cup after a week later. So it was a goodbye, but we had training the next day. So and prepared the final, completely different. This time, it's over after the final whistle. So, and we know it for a while and all these kind of things. So, yes. Will be trickier.
So what's the last thing then that you will do officially as Liverpool manager? Will it be when you walk out of Anfield on Sunday?
No. We have a party afterwards, and I got people tell me I have a speech in a stadium. Then we have an event after the game. People told me I have a speech there. I had a speech now. I had a speech yesterday. I had a lot of interviews. and then, so after the party and the speech, then we have a week after last match day, there's a ceremony, I think. That will be there. So I'm not sure we'll call that an official whatever. And that's then probably last time. But again, I don't see it like that. I know I will not be the manager anymore. But what in my mind, it's, and it's really important, but that's why I mention it so often, I stay the ambassador for the foundation. So I have the key of the city, and I don't want to take that lightly. I don't want. That means, I'm pretty sure the club does need my help in the future, but I might be able to help the city a little bit with a few things, with showing up, putting some attention on different things. And I would love to do that, to be honest. And so I will, not as a threat, but I'll be back.
And you have the accent for it and everything. Well, what about the future for the club? I just think back to the League Cup final and those young players coming on and managing to lift a trophy. Does that make you optimistic for the future for the club?
I told the boys, right, it's an incredible squad. So we didn't make it. But nobody has to be overly critical about that. It's a young team, blah, blah, blah. We were unlucky with injuries and how players came back. And so a couple of things. There's nothing about the quality of the squad. The age group is fantastic. Super experienced players, world-class players, super talented boys. Position twice everywhere. Yes, space for improvement if the club or your manager want to do that. For sure, space for improvement here and there. But the quality is there, is absolutely outstanding. So, character really, really good. Again, and I told the boys, it's good. It sounds, everything is sad and emotional, but it's good for them to hear a new voice, to get new sessions, different meetings, kind of that. That's all good. That opens up your mind and you can go with fresh legs again. I had players in my office the last few days saying goodbye on a personal level, tears in their eyes. It's so wonderful. But I'm not in doubt about our relationship. Not at all. It's fantastic. It was fantastic all the time. But we cannot stay together just because we are used to each other. We must be all constantly being pushing for the next step, pushing for the next step. And that's an important part of my job. So I can give energy to other people. But for that, I need to have it myself. And that's not exactly like it was before. Maybe that will be different in a year, two or three, I don't know, and then we'll see what happens. But yeah, we will see that.
Do you know what's next?
Holiday. Champions League final with Dortmund. Yes. Got invited. So we'll watch that.
You have connections at the club.
Uh-huh.
They got you a ticket, it's all nice.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah. Is there any way you can go? That now when you go on holiday to completely switch off, to get away from all of this, is there any way you can go where nobody says, oh, Jürgen, what about Liverpool?
Can I have an autograph? Yeah. Can I have a selfie?
Yeah.
It's not that I tried a lot, so I didn't have time. So I had time, but a summer holiday for me at least was like between the season, like falling on the first available sunbed and switching off as far as you can and having a phone here and talking to agents, sporting directors, stuff like that. Having no training sessions, yes, but the rest was pretty much still going on. And so that means I didn't see 1% of the world, so nothing. But now we will do nothing, we'll watch Euros, blah, 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 here and there. Really looking forward to that. And then holiday, doing nothing. And then the plan is start to travel. That's it. And then we'll see how that goes.
And be a husband and a father and a grandfather.
100%. Can't wait to be that. Yeah, no, it's all good. I'm how I said, I can't wait for life. For the life after the career, and now let's see what that means to me. I people ask me I just don't know. I never had it, so let's give it a try, and then I tell you.
Thank you, Jürgen.
You're
and I know
welcome.
You don't like the Shankly comparisons, but you made the people happy.
That's good. That was the plan.
Thank you, Jürgen.
Welcome, Kelly.